Prince Philip's funeral request revisited after death hoax resurfaces. Queen's husband wants no fuss. Prince Philip wants a simple funeral. Just recently, the Duke of Edinburgh has become a victim of death hoax again. It has been happening for countless times already in the past years that several netizens just laughed at it because they knew it was not true. Some even sarcastically joked about it, saying that he's been dead 15 times already this year alone. Due to this, the Duke's funeral requests have also resurfaced. According to Express, the 98-year-old royal has already arranged his funeral plans and wanted a little more simple. In fact, he reportedly said, "I want no fuss about it." He may be entitled to a full-blown state funeral, but the Duke has expressed a preference for something a little more simple, and he's been closely involved with the arrangements which are being coordinated by the Lord Chamberlain's office at Buckingham Palace, reporter Zara Moroy said. Rather than lying in state at Westminster Abbey, it's thought that the Duke's body will lie at St. James Palace in state, where Princess Diana lay for several days before her funeral in 1997. As for the funeral itself, the Duke is very particular with the guest list because he wants a more intimate event. He prefers to only have his family, friends, and the heads of state from Commonwealth countries. They will attend a service at St. George's Chapel in Windsor Castle in the style of military funeral. Meanwhile, a 2013 Parliament document explained that the process of deciding when the state funeral would be held for a person other than the sovereign is unclear because it happens so rarely and in long historical intervals. In related news, Prince Philip and Queen Elizabeth II are already in Windsor. The Queen and Duke moved there amid the coronavirus outbreak on Thursday. He was flown by a helicopter from Norfolk to Windsor. The Duke has been living in good form on Sandringham Estate in Norfolk after he resigned from his royal duties. Queen Elizabeth II supports his decision to leave away from Buckingham Palace because the Queen knows that if her husband stays with her, he will be obliged to get involved in the duties at hand, and she believes that he deserves a proper retirement.